I have the Samsung Galaxy S23 here, and today I'll be showing you how to access download mode. This process will work on the base version of the Galaxy S23 series, as well as the Galaxy S23 Plus and the Galaxy S23 Ultra. If Samsung ends up releasing any additional models of the S23 series, for example, like a S23 FE, then these steps will also work on those devices as well. For this to work, you will need to have access to a PC with a USB cable. I have heard that this may also work with a pair of USB headphones or earbuds, since those use a data connection via USB. But I have not been able to test this myself. And since Samsung tends to change things from year to year, it may not work with the Galaxy S23 series. Let me know in the comment section below if you've been able to get this to work with a pair of USB headphones. This will also not work if you try to use a USB cable that is attached to a charger. Again, Samsung requires you to have a data USB connection for you to access special boot modes like download mode and recovery mode, as this is their way of preventing people from accidentally booting into these special boot modes. But before we plug in our USB cable, we first need to power down the Galaxy S23. So bring up the power menu by holding the power button, or by tapping the power button within the quick settings panel. Then selecting the power off option and tapping it to confirm you want to shut down the device. You'll also want to wait a few seconds after you see the screen go black, just to make sure that the smartphone has completely shut down. Then, when you're ready, go ahead and grab that USB cable that is connected to your desktop or laptop PC. And then we're going to need to press and hold both the volume up and volume down buttons during this process. You can either use two fingers to hold those two buttons down, or you can position your hand so that you're pressing both volume buttons with just one finger. Either way, this will only work if you're able to press both volume up and volume down buttons and continue holding those buttons down during this process. So let's hold these two buttons. And while those two buttons are pressed, we're going to insert the USB cable while continuing to hold those two volume buttons. Once you see the screen transition to this color, then you can let go of the volume buttons. So this is actually just a splash screen before we can get into the Galaxy S23 download mode page. From here, we're given the option to continue by pressing the volume up button, which will take us into download mode, or reset, which will reboot the smartphone and take us back into Android by pressing the volume down button. And if you have enabled OEM unlocking mode beforehand, you'll also get another option here that will initiate the bootloader unlock process. But I'll save that for another video. There's even a feature that will show a barcode by pressing the power button. But let's press the volume up button, and you'll see the screen transition into the actual Galaxy S23 download mode page. Here, you'll see various bits of information about the device, including the current binary ROM installed, whether factory reset protection, aka FRP, is enabled or not, if the OEM unlock option is enabled or not, if Knox has been tripped or not, and more. Most of us will be booting into download mode so that we can flash a firmware with a program called Odin. So if this is your goal, this is where you would open up the program on your PC and begin installing your ROM. When you're done with download mode, we can reboot out of it and go back to the Android operating system by following the instructions on the screen. This is done by pressing and holding the volume down button and the power button at the same time, and continuing to hold these buttons down for more than 7 seconds. I do want to make note that this screen will always tell you to not turn off the device, and that is good advice if you're actively in the middle of flashing a firmware with Odin. However, as long as you're not currently installing anything to the Galaxy S23, Galaxy S23 Plus, or the Galaxy S23 Ultra, then you can ignore that. Even though it says downloading right here, and that makes it seem like it is actively downloading something, unless you have initiated that with a program like Odin or Heimdall, then you're safe to reboot with this button combination. So again, we just need to press the power and volume down buttons, continue holding them for more than 7 seconds, and you'll see the screen go black as it has forced the phone to reboot. And this boot back into Android shouldn't take long at all, unless you have reset the phone with a new firmware. Then the boot up process will be as fast as it normally is. I hope this video helped anyone who is curious about how to boot into download mode on the Galaxy S23 series. If you get stuck along the way, have any questions about this process, or any other questions regarding Android, then please feel free to leave a comment down below, and I'll see if I can help and reply as quickly as I can.